Hello and welcome to this edition of County Connection. I am County Commissioner Kevin Barnhardt and I'm a committee of one today. I have several items that I've updated the community with in the past, and I have some updated information on some other new items, but hopefully everybody's being safe and healthy out there as we're going through this Delta variant, and everyone's mindful of the need to get vaccinated and also to continue to practice social distancing, masking where appropriate, thoroughly washing your hands and things like that. It's probably something that's gonna be with us for quite an extended period of time, but we wanna make sure everybody's safe and healthy out there. So again, good afternoon. One of the first things I wanna talk about is a very recent change in the county, where the county commissioners meet on Thursday morning at 10 a.m. traditionally, almost every Thursday. We have decided as a board to take some of our meetings on the road. So we had our first one last week at Wyomissing Library. We were hosted by Wyomissing Borough officials, the mayor and a council person, and it was very well received. We had probably a dozen people in the audience we don't normally see at commissioners meetings in downtown Reading. And we also have a virtual audience. We want to continue to do hybrid meetings where you can come in person to the meeting on the 13th floor of the Services Center at 10 o'clock on Thursday morning. Or, for example, the on-the-road meetings we're going to be doing every quarter. Our next one will be on December 16th, the third Thursday of December at Muhlenberg Township office. Meeting starts at 7 o'clock, 7 p.m., and we will have representatives of Muhlenberg Township make some presentations. It gives them the opportunity to talk to a greater community, not just to Muhlenberg Township residents, but to the greater Berks County community, gives them that opportunity. So I think this is a very forward step, an engagement process, if you will, for the commissioners to be able to be on the road. We did need some additional new technology, some new microphones, one of those OWLs, which is a 360 dimensional camera. Still working on a few of the bugs, but like anything else, there are usually bugs, but they get worked out in the process. So welcome to each and every one of you who would like to see us in Muhlenberg Township. And then for 2022, we already have four municipalities who would like to host us at their respective municipal buildings or fire station or library. So we're going to try to be in different quadrants of the county in 2022 to give everyone the opportunity to meet the county commissioners and also to discuss items. One of the more recent items of interest is a controlled deer hunt in Antietam Lake Park. A controlled deer hunt is for antlerless deer. I was told actually deer and deers is correct, but I like deer as singular and plural. This has come about through a cooperative effort we have through the U.S. Department of Agriculture. They have taken in partnership with the county to basically review potential archers, people that are well-versed in the art of hunting with bow and arrow. They've gone through safety training and proper protocol because the deer, and it's not their fault, believe me, I understand that we are taking away most of their natural habitat, if not all of their natural habitat, creating environmental issues for them. But in so doing, they have so much less area to graze. They are overly consuming some of the areas in the Mount Penn Preserve area, specifically Antietam Lake Park. So this will be a controlled thinning of the herd. The animals will be they will be processed and the meat will be utilized by people. This is not going to be laying waste anywhere. So it's a good step in the right direction to preserve the foliage and the trees and so forth in the Mount Penn Preserve. And I know there was some pushback from people, not so much about the deer hunt, but not being made aware of the opportunity to hunt. Our Park and Rec Department is actively taking names and information from people who potentially might be part of a phase two if enough deer aren't thinned out in the process. We also understand from our friends at the city of Reading. They may want to expand this deer hunt into areas of Mount Penn that are city property. So again, it's something that is unfortunately necessary, but it's something that we probably wanted to do for a period of time, but this became the most opportune time to do this. So I will try to keep you updated on that as well. Another recent sad event that took place a little while ago here in the city and the surrounding community is a spike in overdoses related to heroin. And basically it's typically been heroin and fentanyl, but this was also laced with a synthetic poison, as our district attorney would call it, a poison, which created well over 101 overdoses from this bad heroin, which was laced. We have put into place with our SOS Berks, which is our Save Our Community Opioids Coalition through the Council on Chemical Abuse. This is National Recovery Month, so it's critically important that we work in lockstep with law enforcement. This tragic occurrence was really something that was knuckled down to very quickly and expeditiously with the city police, the county detectives, and some surrounding municipal agencies that found the perpetrators of this poison and had them arrested within 48 to 72 hours. We hope this is abated, but again, it does show the critical need for education and understanding for those with substance use disorders beyond just heroin, but there are so many of these addicting chemicals out there in our community that we are really redoubling our efforts with SOS Berks, the Berks Opioids Coalition, which I co-chair with Stan Papademetrio, the executive director of COCA, the Council on Chemical Abuse. We just celebrated National Recovery Walk this past weekend. I would say it was well over 150 people in recovery, active recovery, walked from the Reading Area Community College over the Penn Street Bridge to the pavilion at the West Reading Playground, which then there were some speeches there and some events taking place, as well as a Camp Joy at the North Campus of the county property. So again, it's critically important that if you know someone who has a substance use disorder, someone in your family, a friend, a loved one, please reach out and get them the support and help they need. This is a brain disease. It's not a choice people make. It's an unfortunate circumstance similar to someone who is diabetic or has a heart condition. Those who have an active substance use disorder, this is truly a physical and mental change in them that they need all the support they can get from our community. Somewhat along the same lines, our BSER team, the Berks County Emergency Response Team, which is a cooperative spirit of numerous police agencies in Berks County, we're on a special operations team. If there is a need for a call out, they join forces wherever the municipality might be to help to quell the situation. Generally, these are oftentimes people that are potentially barricaded in their home. They truly have, I would say, overwhelming amount have co-occurring disorders, whether it's drugs, alcohol, mental health. They are desperate. They are looking for an alternative or a solution. So this team has now partnered with the same group of municipalities to have a critical response team, not the mobilization of the equipment as much as mobilization of trained people in the community to come out if they identify someone who has stressors in their lives, mental health issues that they call out the CNT team, which identifies the situation, tries to alleviate the situation. So this again is, for me, is heartwarming to know that our community, although we are 72 municipalities, that we work together. We still have those identities as municipalities, but we work together in a team approach because people that have issues or problems don't know borders one from the other. They just need help. And I think this was exacerbated by the pandemic and the closures and the isolation for many people. We've seen certainly an increase in overdoses. We've seen an increase in suicides. These are the side effects, for want of a better term, of a pandemic and a closure and people being isolated and not being able to be in a normal routine, a normal process. And as I said in the beginning of the program, we can get back to normal if we all knuckle down and know what's best for not just us. It's about our community. It's about our loved ones, our friends, and our family. When you get vaccines, it's not only for you. Certainly, it protects you to a large extent, but also protects people that are around you. So let's think about others as we move into the fall of this year. And then, of course, we'll have a natural uptick in those sort of communicable diseases, and flu shots and things like that are going to be promoted once again in the community, along with the vaccine against COVID-19. So we also have elections on the table. The election is the first Tuesday in November, November 3rd. Polls will be open on that Tuesday from 7 a.m. till 8 p.m. The county mans and operates 202 polling precincts or locations throughout the community, throughout Berks County. We are always looking for additional poll workers, those who could be a judge of elections, that person oversees that precinct. And then we have machine inspectors, minority, majority inspectors. It's getting critically important because more than half of the people we have working polls now are not, they're, some of them are elected positions and a lot of them remain vacant. So we have one person in election services who does nothing more every day, should say nothing more, day in and day out, basically recruits poll workers for these primary and general elections here in Berks County. It's, if you're interested, the pay is $200 for a judge of elections and $180. You're also paid when you come into training, whether here at the Services Center or the Ag Center in Burn Township. We want to have more and more people on a list to help us with elections, because still we have the majority of people do come to polls and vote. But now we also have through Act 77, the mail-in process, the mail-in voting, that also takes an awful lot of time and energy from our department. And in the prior two, three elections that we had mail-in ballots, we utilized county employees to augment the election process. Now, thankfully, in November, our county employees have a vacation day on election day. So they can basically come in and help us on their day off to open up and to sort through and then scan the mail-in ballots. So if you have applied for mail-in ballot, you will be receiving that in the mail. You have the option of turning that back in to the Services Center front entrance or the Ag Center in Burn Township, or do what I do and my wife does, is we put them in the mailbox and they get back to election services and then are scanned in and uploaded on election day. County Commissioners Association, along with my colleagues who are active in the County Commissioners Association, have been lobbying long and hard with the Election Reforms Committee, on which I serve, to have the state legislature, the General Assembly, and the governor modify Act 77 to allow for us to pre-canvass at least 3 to 5 days ahead of Tuesday. Pre-canvassing is nothing more than being able to open these envelopes, scan those ballots in to a disk, not to report them, but to have them queued up for election night, because what happens traditionally is at 8 o'clock, the polls close and people want to know why you don't have a results. Well, there's a lot of things going on behind the scenes why you can't sit on BCTV or some of the other news outlets and look for the results. It's not that quick. The polls have to be closed. The equipment has to be closed out. The disks or flash drives, whatever you know you want to call them, don't call them disks or flash drives and sticks, have to be transported to either downtown Reading or to the Ag Center to be uploaded into the mainframe. And then those votes are basically on the computer system here at Election Services. I don't want to get political, and that's not what this show is about, but the continued request to audit the election of November. I'm not going to litigate that here on BCTV, but one of the things that the people that keep demanding these recounts and this audit of the system, there's nothing to audit. It has been audited twice. We have followed every rule that the Commonwealth has handed down to the county willingly and capably. The margin, it's way within the margin of error. And sadly, there's nothing to look at on the machines. The ballot marking devices at the polls are a ballot marking device. They actually put the what you're going to vote on a card, and then the card is loaded into a scanner, and that scanner then is uploaded to a flash drive. Those disks, those chips, yeah, those flash drives are uploaded into the system, and then they are used for the next election. So keep in mind, the November election was November, and then we had a primary in May. So the same disks that were used for the general election were now cleared and put in the system for the primary election. So those who think they can go back and audit the election or try to find some irregularities, they don't really know what they're looking for because there is nothing to look for. And I speak for Election Services in Berks County. I don't speak for other counties or in the other states. I speak as the chair of the election board here in Berks County. I think those requests coming directly to Berks County and questioning the motives of our employees or their intent, I think that is just disrespectful to people who work their butts off for the county of Berks, whether it's our full-time employees or those election people that work at the polls. I think that's a true insult to our residents and our citizens here who take this upon themselves. They swear an oath that they are going to do the right thing. They're not going to tamper with anything or do anything that is against the laws. I think if you are an active voter and you go to the polls, you can see the dedication of people at the polls. And I can speak firsthand about the people that work here in Election Services and the integrity that they have each and every day doing their job. They're just trying to do their job, just like everyone else, just like you are trying to do your job. And I think it's an unfair critique or criticism of these folks. You know, I can take it. I have broad shoulders. But when it comes to our people here, I think enough's enough. Moving on, we are going to be purchasing. We have purchased electronic poll books, which will eventually replace the paper documents that you sign when you go to the polls. We're going to be demoing 5 of these poll books in the general election in November at 5 of our larger polls. And then we will have them fully implemented for the primary election in 2022. So the books will not be there. The laborious effort of paging through the books looking for Kevin Barnhardt's name and then turning the book around will be on an iPad. You can come in and scan in your driver's license, the barcode on the back, list your name and your address. So this will verify that I'm in the right poll. I vote in South Heidelberg. So it will verify I'm in the right place. The beauty of the electronic poll books is that if I end up in the wrong place, say I go into Shillington and put my license up against the scanner and it says, you live in South Heidelberg Township, that's where you should be voting. They can certainly direct me to the right poll, because if you end up in the wrong poll, you can't vote on the machines. They cannot deny you the ability to, if you refuse to leave Shillington to go to South Heidelberg, they will give you a provisional paper ballot. But let me tell you something, there are different races in Shillington than there are in South Heidelberg Township. So maybe some of the top line, if there's a senatorial race or a gubernatorial race or a state legislature race, you might get lucky. But when it comes to school boards or your municipal officials, these ballots can't be counted because I can't vote for borough council people in Shillington when I'm a resident of South Heidelberg Township. So it's important for voters to be educated, to be knowledgeable where they belong, where they vote, voting on local issues. I can't stress that enough. Turnout for me is never good enough. Even in a presidential, when we're at 70 or 75%, people are happy. I think we're the other 25%, we're the other 30%. If you took the time and effort to register to vote, then why aren't you voting? And I don't want to hear, gee, there's nothing to vote for, my vote doesn't matter. Believe me, we sit every year, especially in the primary, and there are some races as little as, you know, in some of the smaller municipalities where we've had to break ties, where there were so many, you know, maybe 25 votes for this person and 25 votes for the next person, and we had to break a tie. Every vote is important. Every vote matters. And what's more important than those elected officials are the voters that put them in place, give them their trust to carry out those duties for little, if no pay in most of our municipalities. So take elections and voting seriously. If you take anything away from this meeting today, please avail yourself of the opportunity to vote. Another initiative here at the county is Imagine Berks. It's our most recent stab at an economic development priorities for the community, for jobs, for employers to have a real roadmap or a plan for us to carry through. Where should development be? Where should it not be? Who's likely to be an area that really can flourish from industrial, commercial, manufacturing to build a tax base? Because obviously I don't like to. No one likes to pay any more taxes than we need to. But we need a healthy blend of various taxing entities to keep our taxes in check. Of course, I can refer back to the state again, where tax reform has been an issue for ongoing 40 years and traveled to other states, many other states. Florida, for example, they have a 7% tax, sales tax on everything, but their property taxes are significantly lower. Quite honestly, I was comparing numbers with where I live and in Florida. My tax would be down 90% when it comes to a property tax in Florida, for an example. Now, of course, you're going to make up some of that when you go to the grocery store or the hardware store and buy, because everything's 7%. I was at the grocery store this weekend and spent 70 some dollars, and only about $1.85 of that product was taxable. So for people to think the only solution is, you know, sales tax, just keep in mind that some of that lowering of this of the property tax gets eaten up by the sales tax. But we need to find a different mechanism to tax. We hate the word tax, but we need money to operate government effectively and efficiently. But there has to be an easier way to do it. So Imagine Berks is going to get us on a roadmap, a glide path, if you will. And this is not something that is going to be looked at every 20 years and updated. This has to be updated on an annual basis, probably reinforced every 5 years. We have to be fluid in this environment and in the environment we are. Who would have thought, what, 20 years ago, there'd be anything other than Amazon? Amazon was selling books online. Next thing you know, it's the world's largest corporation, doing billions and billions of dollars a day, probably a billion dollars an hour, moving materials. So it's important for us to be flexible in our economic development strategy here in Berks County to attract and retain good people, good jobs, good employers, and having a real stable base. You don't want to be a community has one massive employer like a auto factory that employs thousands and thousands of people. And then, as we know, recently, there's been a microchip shortage and a lot of auto plants have been shut down until that supply chain can catch up. So we need to keep ourselves diversified. We have to find areas we're strong in. You know, batteries is a huge one. Healthcare is a big one. Food processing is another big one. We can capitalize on those and get even bigger and stronger here in Berks County. Along with that, we also need sufficient housing to house the employees. It's best if your employees work in your county or your township. It's okay for people to travel from different counties, but you'd really like to have that in-migration as opposed to the out-migration of people that live in Berks County but have to work elsewhere because they don't have the job they're looking for in Berks County, something we're really looking at effectively. Our jail has become, again, an issue with respect to trying to get back up to speed on the eventual construction of a new jail. We put that on the side during COVID in 2021. We're going to be looking at that again in earnest, seeing what needs to be done and when, because as I've said for years here, it's throwing good money after bad when you are trying to Band-Aid and rubber band together a facility that is way past its useful life, not just the 1933 piece, but the 1993 piece. We have to be effective and responsive to the needs of that jail when we look to build a new one and to eventually remove the existing jail because of, you know, new techniques and population management, new ways of looking at inmates as people that need to be rehabilitated and those sorts of things. So we need to expand mental health. We need to expand medical. We need to expand those component parts of a jail, not just jail cells. This isn't about more cells. This is about more interaction with the inmates to get them on the path to become a successful member of society. So with that, just as quickly as I started, I'm going to be finishing up. I have a lot more to talk about, but only 26 minutes to tell you. So looking forward to our next meeting, our next County Connection, which should be in about a month or so. So stay tuned to other episodes of the County Connection. And with that, I'm your County Commissioner, Kevin Barnhardt, signing off for today. See you next time.